Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's Big D Vinyl 2012 here on YouTube. You probably see my video, my other two videos up to at the moment with of my Transformers collections part 1 and 2, and now it's part 3 of another. I've got another update for you, Transformers. The collection. I've got an extensive update now. I've got about 26 Transformers now in total. This is part 3, by the way, and a couple of other things I want to show you first before I get into the Transformers themselves. That, as you've seen on the last video, this is the Transformers the Movie T-shirt, which I got for Christmas. Also, in my Transformers collection, I now have this now. It's the all thirteen discs of the first entire generation series of Transformers, all on DVD here. 14 discs, those. Plus also the, if anybody remembers back from the 80s when they used to have the audio box came out with the books on, and also cassette. I've got all three of the books here as well. There's Autobots Lightning Strike right there. It's Megatron's Fight for Power, and also Autobots Fight Back. Extensive collections for the Transformers and that. So, without further ado, it's not them you will actually see though, it's the robots, innit? So, then, in previous Transformers, that's where to begin. We have previous Transformers, we've got one here now. This is Autobot Jazz, remastered from the G1 generation. There's Jazz right here. That's Jazz. Converts from robot into a sports car. I'll show you that. Robot into a sports car. So that's Jazz. The Titans Return. Not Titans Return, sorry. Power of the Primes version Autobot Jazz, this is. It comes with this chest panel right there, and that's that fluorescent bit at the can be pulled off to form one of the Titans Return Titan Headmasters, can be put inside there. It's supposed to fit on the underbelly of his chest, which is like that somehow, and we'll return that one later. So that's Autobot Jazz. Let's put him one side there. Next up, Titans Return range. Back to the Titans Return range. Remodeled from the G1 generation series. This is Titans Return version of Perceptor. Everywhere. Converts from robot into a telescope. If you just actually see it there, this is the telescope. I'm just about to see the blue eyepiece there at the back can be rotated and extended. It's Titans Return Perceptor, and the Titans Return head comes off to form a robot called Convex. I'll just show him here for you if the camera can pick it up. This is Convex. This is Convex right here. That's Convex. Thank you. So that's convex. Also, convex can be plugged into Perceptor's weapon. I'll just show you there. You can see it. If the camera can take it. There you'll see. Can actually sit in Perceptor's weapon. The transformation of this is fairly simple. So I'll show you what the Perceptor transforms into a spy telescope right here. So what it basically is. With the Perceptor here, fold his arms down. Well, his fists actually go in there like so. Just bear with me a second. And transform. You take his arms up like that. And the actual main body part there, where his head was, flips up like that. Bear with me on this one. And somehow it fits into these grooves here. His arms actually go up, actually, on the other way. Should bring it all in shape. Sorry, the telescope just fell off. Sorry about that. But it can easily be put back on, though. I think I've got it now. You actually dig in there like that, like so. And next up, so they actually go into these grooves here. I think you get the gist of it anyway. It's like it forms like a telescope. So just basically transforming back into a robot. Just getting back into robot mode. the telescope back on right here. And convex, transform convex back into Perceptor's head. Perceptor's weapon back on his fists, like so. And there he is again. There he is again in back in robot mode. That's Perceptor. And that's Perceptor. Perceptor and Jazz up to now at the moment. Next up, is the biggest one in my collection now. You've probably seen this on YouTube already, and he's here. The big giant monster himself, which is Power Surge Optimus Prime. This is Power Surge Optimus Prime right here. I'll just bring the camera around so you can see him in more detail. This is Power Surge Optimus Prime. Very, very, very huge, giant robot here. And one amazing thing about this, you know, he has lights and sounds. If the camera can pick this up. You've got his lights there on his chest, on his shoulders there. There you can see some of his lights there. This robot. Just get the. Just bear with me a second. Get the sun up. There we go. This other one here actually came with him. That's actually part of his chest. That's part of his chest plate, which also performs more sounds like that. Let's get Optimus Prime here into shot. He will continue doing that, by the way. And to transform this, it's just basically... That's how it was, I had just seen him. Let's just take his feet down, rotate the wings, and also forms into a bird, like so. But if the camera can take it, there's a little, the authentic Autobot symbol there, on the bird's chest, together with also with Optimus Prime there. It forms into a bird. Like that. So simple for that one. Power Surge Optimus Prime. Also comes with this fluorescent kind of like sword right here. It's there. And as he's just been activated into a Power Surge mode, you can actually see his he's got like an armed mask now, as you can see there as a close up. Power Surge Optimus Prime right there. So just get him back. If you want to see the transformation of this one, just watch the other videos that other people have reviewed about this on YouTube. So that's Power Surge Optimus Prime. Just get Optimus Prime there to the side. So, and speaking of Optimus Prime, and speaking of another version, the three versions of Optimus Prime here now that I have. One-step changer that I've shown you in part one of Optimus Prime. That's Power Surge version of Optimus Prime that you've just seen, and here is another version of Optimus Prime. This one is part of the Transformers Combiner Force range. This is Optimus Prime with his little companion here on High Test. This is High Test right here. Transformation on this one is quite simple too. There's also flip down his side panels there. Then that bit flips up. And it like forms into a like cannon. Into a cannon for Optimus Prime's fist there. Or you can take that down. You can take that centerpiece down and form it like that into a small armored tank. As you can see it right there before your eyes there. That's High Test. Transforming back again, quite simple again. It's quite simple once again. Take that bit down of this back bit to reform High Test legs. Clips back onto place there, and there's High Test back in robot mode there again. So that's High Test. This is Optimus Prime right here. This is the Combiner Force Optimus Prime. Transformation on this one is quite simple too, in which I'll show you how to transform it right now. You take that up, that goes up like that, like so. His feet, like fall back. Fall back into place. There's that in between his legs there. Has got that little. Has got like a small peg on there, which just clips. It just basically clips in like that.
legs. Going down like so. Wait a minute. I think I'm doing something wrong here. Just bear with me. Should. Oh wait, there we go. Oh, boy. These has to go down. Go down into the back part there. And there is in truck mould. And that's in truck mould. And the action of the combiner force is also you take high test again and retransform him back into his cannon mould again. The time you flip the bottom bit back up like that, and then just watch this. As soon as you plug this in, it's a little groove right there. Optimus Prime converts into action mode like this. And that's what he looks like. That's Optimus Prime and high test right there. And like I've just shown you once again, high test. Put him back in robot mode here now. ITS back in robot mode, and Optimus Prime. Let's convert Optimus Prime back into robot mode. But the only thing is though, to convert Optimus Prime in robot mode, you have to make sure that these are pegged back into the sides here. That. You take his arms and then fold them back up like that, like so. Twist his arms back out. You fold the front, take the front of the cab. Back into position to form Optimus Prime's back there. And you fold his legs back up. And there you go. There's Optimus Prime back in robot mode. I'll take his swivel his arms straight. Let's put Optimus Prime's arm straight right here. And then they go back together again, both in robot mode. And like I've shown you with his with the high test cannon mode, if you just transform him back in another thing you can do with this, he can be used as Optimus Prime's weapon. If we just transform a high test back here. But just providing that bit there is still down. And then just somehow slots into his arm. Please don't do this. This is live on YouTube. Don't do this. Please don't do this to me. It could be like that. Into a cannon mold. You can actually do it that way. If it's your choice, but you don't have to. Just transform a high test once again back into robot mode again. So that's it. So that's Optimus Prime and high test. The combiner force range, same with Soundwave, which I brought you back in part one. So I'll just put Optimus Prime and sound test back to one side. Other robots we have here now is, after I've shown you in part one, is the one step changer of Sideswipe is here. This is one step changer of Sideswipe that I've shown you in part one, but now I have another version of Sideswipe, which is also another combiner force one, and this is my previous one. This is a recent one that I've just got. This is Sideswipe and with his little companion here, Great Bite. This is Great Bite. The camera can pick it up there. It's like a little monster. Little monster right there. Simple, and this one actually transforms into an airplane. So basically, that, the back part there with his cannon flips up. With these legs, just at the top of the wingspan there, and there it forms into an airplane right there, and let's show you this in comparison. With this is the Combiner Force version of Sideswipe, together with this one, which is also Sideswipe. So basically, transformation of this one is quite simple as well. All you do is take his arms, fold his arms down like so, and the back of his feet here, fold them up at the back, and at the back here the camera can pick it up right there where my finger is. It's like a little peg there that just basically slots in like that, so. And then take the back part of his legs to form that little small groove was small grooves just there, if they can, just slots right into place to come to form the back of the vehicle. And then the front part right here, it goes all the way down there to conform the from the front spoil of the car. And his arms come up and click into position like that, and with the doors, and there he is, his sideswipes car mould. That's the combiner force version of sideswiping the car. Now let's see this one, let's see if it's any different. So basically, I'll just get this this version of sideswipe into position. This is sideswipe. This is the one-step version of sideswipe compared to this version of sideswipe. Except I like this one a lot more better because it's more jazzed up. They both pretty look the same actually, as you can see there. So I'll just put this one to one side. I like showing you with Optimus Prime and High Test, another great action once again with this combiner force range. It's got a little black button there on the top where you can put Great Bite on top there to form in. Let's get it into shot. You push it down onto this super fighting vehicle, which is pretty good stuff here, pretty good stuff. Also you can take Great Bite there and they both can fly. You can do that either way. You can do that either way if possible. It's just totally up to you. And all it is back, and just it's back in car mode like that. Or you can actually turn Great Bite around. The opposite way round, can form a cannon, like a gun cannon there, which is perched on top of Sideswipe's car right there. So the transformation back on this one is just a reverse way round, like I've just shown you. Take the black part there, fold it down towards the cannon, and then twist it round, put Great Bite's legs, and that's Great Bite back in robot mode there. In order to transform Sideswipe back into a robot, you have to have it like that to transform it back into robot mode. So just reverse steps once again, back of the car, fold it back up, take the feet and hold them back out like so. Unpeg the legs, and with this bit though, you have to be very, very careful. Yep, with this bit here, behind Sideswipe's head. Yeah, this bit. You have to be very, very careful because it does actually come off quite easy. So it should actually fold down really, but I'm just going to keep it like that at the moment. That's so. So there's Sideswipe back again in robot mode. But Sideswipe, and that's Sideswipe and Great Bite, another one of the Combiner Force ranges. Other ones right here, we have this one, Transformers The Last Knight, Barricade, Legion Class. It converts into a little posh sport police car. That's a Barricade, but I'm not going to show you how to. I'm not really sure. Another re-edition of a Transformers G1, which is Ratchet. This is Ratchet. The transformation in this one is fairly simple. I'll just show you. Just quickly show you. So the way his arms are there is just basically they go form the car doors. So they flip up like that. There's another peg that there's another peg, sorry, peg right there that just clips in. You have to try and sandwich this in to form the front of the vehicle. It's all just taking shape now, just almost. And it goes all the way in the back of his legs. And just bear with me a second. It's actually, I've done wrong there. Was I had to put the back part of the vehicle in first like that. And then the arms there. Supposed to sandwich in. You go in from underneath. Let's make sure everything's all sandwiched in correctly. And there you have it, that's Ratchet. That's Ratchet right there, a little small ambulance, I think. I'm not too sure there. That's Ratchet. Another This is another Titans Return one. Another new one of mine is called Road Burn. Converts into a nice red Jeep type car, I think. That's Road Burn. Another one in the reform from the Transformers G1 Generations range is Brawn here. This is Brawn. This actual bit here, you can see there with the tire on the top of it, is to use as a weapon. Can be put on his main fist there, or on the side of his fist. It's totally up to you. And the very, 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 very nice detail here with Brawn. A Brawn right there. And transforms into a Land Rover. So I'll show you his transformation for you right now. This is how he's transformed. Fold his feet flat like that. And there's a peg at the back of the legs here. They just clip in there like so. And take the whole back of the vehicle to form it down. There we go. Then take his arms. Take both of his arms. His fist has to be turned 180 degrees. His arms sandwich in there like so. And that bit is his weapon. We'll go on there. And that's Brawn. There's another cool thing about this. So with the Titans Return, this bit right here, the front here of the vehicle actually opens up, so you can put a Titan Master in there. I'll just show you with Convex. Just say Convex off the Perceptor here. Just transform Convex Perceptor's head, and he can go inside there like that. If the camera can pick it up right there, let's get a bit of a close up. As you can see him. You can see Convex there inside Brawn, right there. And he's actually inside there. It's Convex. See him there inside the vehicle. Excuse me. Transformation back again of Brawn. Just reverse back. The back thing of his weapon, just take that off. Just take that off. Just bring the legs back up. There, like that, like so. His back feet. Just twist. Twist back to form his feet. Then his arms. Unpeg them from the side, the front side of the car, to reform. To reform his arms. Twist back 180 degrees back to the right to form his fists. Like so there. And that's Braun. And that's Braun for you there. That's he's back in robot mode again. So it looks like Braun's doing the splits right there. Just get his legs back in check. Put his this bit here, like a form on the back and the side of the fist to form his weapon, like that. So that's Braun. So that's Braun there, right for you. And last but not least. Now, before I leave. Oh, by the way, we've got some Titans Return cards here. That's Braun's card that comes with it, with all his firepower and details there on the back. Same with Roadburn's card. Remember me just showing you Roadburn? That's his card. That's his card to go with it. Titans Return there. And last up is another one, is one more. There's a couple that I've seen a video on YouTube this morning from my pal Bolt Matrix, if you know him. But he called this robot something different. I don't know what he called him now, but it's actually called Sky Shadow. This is a Decepticon Sky Shadow right here. With his weaponry, with his all his weaponry, very very good detail here. But I've not quite figured out how to transform this yet, because I've only just opened it a couple of days ago. But I've not figured out how to transform it yet, so I'm afraid I can't show you. I'm afraid. So this is called Sky Shadow. But his the top of his head there. It's got a Titan Master inside that of his head. Actually comes off, which I've not quite figured out how to do it yet. But I will show you on the next one in part 4 once you get the hang of it. Coming up very very soon with more Transformers. So that's it. Got with Jazz, Perceptor, Roadburn, Power Surge, Optimus Prime, and. Sideswipe, Optimus Prime and High Test, Sideswipe and Great Bite, Broad and Ratchet, and also Perceptor. I've been Big D Vinyl 2012. So enjoy more of my videos by subscribing to me, www.youtube.com/Big D Vinyl. That's VINYL 2012, and I'll see you again soon. Enjoy.